Ah, the moon keeps us company as always. Doesn't it seem to be like omnipresent? Even now, it seems like it's following us no matter what speed we're moving in. If we try to find a scientific explanation behind this, well, for that we need to go on a road trip. This won't do. In a little while. Hey, wake up. Look outside. You see, as we're moving forward, turns out that the trees are also moving backward, rushing at the same speed, right? But then look at that house over there. You see, even the house seems to be moving backward, but a lot slower, right? And what about that mountain which is way out there in the background? That also is moving backwards, but dead slow. Now you see, what's outside, right? The tree, the house, and the mountain. These fall in our field of view. And as we are moving this way, they are moving that way. To understand this, actually, we need to take a closer look from a different view. Now, imagine you're looking at all of this happening from up above. This is what you'd see. See, we're moving on the road. The tree is close to the road. The house is farther away from the road, and the mountain is really far from the road. Now, you know what? We're going to move between these two points, A and B. Now, look, as I move, I'm going to try and keep looking at these objects directly. First, the tree. Let's call this my line of sight. As I move towards point B, in order to keep looking at the tree, I'd have to turn my head through an angle. See? Let's call this the angle of head turn A. Or I can say, if I have to keep looking at the tree, my line of sight would have to turn through an angle A. Is that clear? If that wasn't clear to you, go back a few seconds in the video and rewatch it. Let's do the same thing that we did with the tree now with the house and the mountain. First, the house. When I move from A to B, my line of sight to the house moves through an angle B, which, if you'll notice, is different from angle A. Okay, now with the mountain, this time we get the angle C, which once again is different. Now, you might notice a pattern here. These angles tell us how much an object is moving in our field of view. Now, the greater the angle of head turn, the more that object is going to move in our field of view. Let's take a look. The tree has the greatest angle of head turn. And if you remember, it is what moves the most in our field of view. The house has a smaller angle, angle B, and it moved lesser in our field of view. Remember? The mountain, however, has the least angle, and of course, sure enough, it moves the least in our field of view. And that is it. We have got everything that we need to answer the question, why does the moon seem to be following us? The idea that I just talked about is called parallax. Parallax is the apparent change in an object's position when viewed from two different viewpoints. And it is usually measured as the angle between the two lines of sight. All right, cool, let's get back. Actually, if the mountain is 1 kilometer away from us and it has only a small degree of head turn or angle of head turn, imagine how far the moon must be away from us. No head turn. It is about 380,000 kilometers away from the Earth. While the radius of the Earth is about 6,400 kilometers or so, which means that between the Earth and the Moon, you can fit 29 and a half Earths. That is so far away that even if we were to move across the Earth, looking directly at the Moon, we would need a head turn of about 2 degrees. Isn't that fascinating? This is why it barely moves in our field of view. That gives us an illusion that it's following us. For more really cool content like this, and for more really cool learning like this, download BYJU’S, the learning app.